Welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals, Seth Lederman. Seth, thank you for joining me again.
Thank you for having me on, Natalie.
As always, and it's always a lot of fun when we get to chat about some very interesting news. The company has just announced a new research agreement with the University of Maryland, Baltimore, for learning how we can prevent transplant rejection in humans. What is this research agreement all about?
Thanks, Natalie. We're very excited about this agreement. We're developing a therapeutic called TNX-1500, and it's a monoclonal antibody that in animals has blocked transplant rejection. There are two basic kinds of transplant rejection. One is when a human donates an organ to another human, and that's called allotransplantation. And another kind of transplantation where the organ is donated by an animal and put into a human, and that's called xeno, X-E-N-O. And so we've already been collaborating, for example, with Harvard University on the allotransplant program and had some experience with xeno. But this agreement with University of Maryland at Baltimore is to work on studying our antibody to block the rejection of xenotransplants. In this case, the transplanted organs will come from genetically engineered pigs who have been developed by the Revivicor division of United Therapeutics. Mm-hmm. We're very excited to work with University of Maryland, particularly because they got quite a lot of attention last year for doing a heart transplant of a genetically engineered pig organ into a man who lived several weeks. So this was really groundbreaking research, and the studies that we're doing now will support their regulatory filings to follow on that experience.
Mm-hmm. And when it comes to the process of the research behind it, how exactly is the monoclonal antibody, could it be helpful when it comes to preventing rejection for transplants?
Well, in allotransplantation, the human immune system has to deal with a transplanted human organ, and that's one kind of immune response. For xenotransplant, the human immune system of the recipient has to deal with an organ that came from pigs, from a pig. So it's really a fundamentally different type of immune response. Mm-hmm. And what scientists have found is that our antibody, anti-CD40 ligand antibodies, some others, are, I'd call them nice to have for allotransplant, meaning they seem to work and they seem to have potentially some therapeutic advantages over other things that are out there. There's still none are approved for therapy. This is all experimental work. But for xenotransplantation, where the organ comes from a pig, it seems like this really requires an antibody like ours, an antibody to CD40 ligand. So the only long-term graft acceptances in xeno that I'm aware of have involved some way of blocking the CD40 ligand function. So we're very excited that University of Maryland wants to work with us and now will be studying our antibody in their exciting work about xenotransplant.
It does sound really exciting. Thank you so much for stopping by to share this big update with us.
Thank you, Natalie.
Again, the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals, Seth Lederman.